The answer to what frailty is quite complex. As of yet, frailty doesn't have one generally accepted definition, and that means many different interpretations exist. But it's likely we can all visualize a person who has frailty, as the word frailty is generally interpreted as being weak, delicate, or fragile. But these are some of the more official definitions that have been provided. And although these definitions are all quite complex, they do highlight some key points. Firstly, frailty is medically relevant, as it can help inform clinicians in their treatment strategies and diagnoses. Unfortunately, many people living with frailty remain undiagnosed, and it is not until the occurrence of a major crisis, such as a fall, where an individual is seen by a doctor, and at this point they are being made aware of their frailty. But actually, even in these situations where injury or disease are the main cause of concern, frailty still often gets overlooked and remains undetected. The second thing to notice is that frailty reflects a state of increased vulnerability. The vulnerability in this regard is to the risk of developing dependencies, such as a disability. Later on, we will look a bit more into frailty compared with disability, but for now, a similar example is when your GP measures your blood pressure. If your blood pressure is deemed too high, your GP could take action and prescribe medication. This is not because a high blood pressure is the problem, but what it does do is that it makes you more vulnerable to having a serious event, such as a cardiac arrest or a stroke. Frailty is similar in that sense. It increases the risk of disability or extends the recovery from illness. For example, tripping over a street curb can lead to a fall and to subsequent hospitalization, while frailty can firstly have caused the fall, but can also extend the recovery process. Thirdly, the unique aspect of frailty is that it provides a different perspective to many other diseases that a clinician would look for. It really looks across different systems in your body. What this means is that it looks at a more holistic approach than normally is done in healthcare, where, for example, diabetes is based on measurement of blood glucose levels, or osteoporosis is based on your bone mineral density. In contrast, frailty is not based on a single system in your body. It reflects a whole body status, whereby the weakest link can make you more vulnerable to developing disability. And often, that means including aspects of your daily functioning, such as strength and endurance, rather than just looking at the biological components. So, frailty is multidimensional, but not specifically linked to one physical characteristic. Fourthly, frailty is dynamic. It can change over time. Most of us have heard of the term frail, and often associated with aging or getting old. But the truth is that frailty is not the same as getting older. That means that individuals should not be labelled as being frail, but simply that they have frailty at this point in time.